So you just go around and
our doctors have already given up on us, but Jesus by himself came and sent his angels into the room where I was to have this baby, and he brought me back to life. 11 months after that, I went into depression. I was to end my life because the devil wanted me to end my life. But that's because I have a destiny and a purpose and a plan. The devil knew it and he wanted to stop it. But you know the good thing about Jesus is whatever the enemy plans for you, he turns it around for his glory. Praise God. So I'm standing here today to let you know that Jesus is the only way.
Amen.
I came out in cold, I came out in destitution just to let you know that.
Sorry,
there's no other way, no other truth other than Jesus. I have this big smile on my face because I've seen it come true for me, my family, my children, and everyone around me over and over again. Just 3 weeks ago, a woman was, missing. His family was looking for her, and they didn't find her. They didn't know. For 1 week, they were looking for her. Do you know, she slept in her house. She fell down. For 1 week, they were looking. When we prayed, the Lord said, don't give up on her. She's under my care. 1 week after that, I said, okay, God is saying, go and check, in the house where she was. The police broke into the house, and they found her lying, not dead. So she was in her house for 1 week under the grace of God. And she's still living today. I don't know who is under the sound of my voice. I just want to encourage you that Jesus is the only way. Without him, we can do nothing. The breath we are breathing today is because of him.
Sister, can I just ask you a question? Oh, in Jesus, what did he do on the cross? Why did he die on that cross?
Now, the reason he came to die as a baby. Don't forget that, the Word, what the Bible says, at the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. Amen. So Jesus came as the Son of God. Though he had all the power in this world, but he chose to come as a baby, born by a woman, a male mortal. Even he chose Mary to birth him again as a baby, being humble enough to be born in a manger. Now, a manger is where animals are kept. But the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords and the Lion of the Tribe of Judah, the Ancient of Days, the Omnipotent, Omnipresent, Omniscient God, chose to die, to be born in a manger just because of my sake and your sake. I was in sin. I wasn't a righteous person before. But God, because of his mercy, he said, I'm not going to allow you wallow in sin. I'm going to come die for your sake just to show you the right path. Praise God. So he came to die. We're talking about Christmas. A lot of people want to talk about Christmas, about the chicken and the Santa, but they don't really know the reason why we celebrate Christmas. So the reason we Christians are really happy about Christmas celebration is because that Christ, the King of Kings, came as a baby. Humble enough that he came to die, divinity came to die for humanity. Divinity came to die for humanity. So he died on the cross, nailing all our sins, all our sorrows, all our pains, all our everything, all the things that we go through just for us to be saved and to be with him in heaven on the last day. That is why he came.
Are we preaching religion where you've got to do all the rules and things, or are we talking about a relationship? What is it? Is it religion or relationship? In a second, after this.
So for me, like where we started, I'm talking about relationship. It's a personal encounter. You know, when you have a friend, you have a friendship with that friend, you can talk about that friend freely because now you know who this friend is. But if I give you a rule about this friend, you're not coming. You don't have a relationship with this person. So you are only told, don't go there, sit down, stand up. But if I have a friend, I'm relaxed with you. Isn't it amazing that when you pray to God, you are free to ask him any question? Why can I approach you today? I can approach you because you found the love of Jesus. You have not put any rule why I cannot preach on this gospel, isn't it? It's the love of God. It's not about religion. It's just about Jesus. Jesus is all why we are here. The love, that's encounter. When you have a personal encounter, your life is transformed for life. You can now speak to the sick. You can now speak to the sick. You can and they will move just because of the power and the name of Jesus.
Give me a testimony on the church. Tom, you can just ask one question. One question, bro. And then I'm going to let this guy talk, yeah?
I was doing the debate.
Why do you call it the devil's lettuce?
He does a wacky backy.
Why do I call it wacky backy? Well, it says...
I've never heard of this lettuce thing, right?
The thing is about drugs. Drugs mess your mind up. Yeah? Right? Jesus Christ will set you free. This guy's got an amazing testimony. Just listen to this guy.
Yeah, my friend. I was addicted. I was so addicted that I couldn't spend a day, I couldn't spend an hour being awake without being high. Because something was missing in my life. I didn't have peace. I had no peace of mind. I was scared of everyone. I was absolutely terrified of everyone I saw. I hated everyone. I was bitter. I was downcast. I would hide down the back alleys to try and get my drugs, to try and get something to fix this pain. But my friends, the devil's name in Greek or Latin is drugs. The name for the devil is drugs, and the devil will offer you a false paradise. The devil will offer you false fulfillment. He will offer you something and say, this is all you need. You don't need to go the way of the cross. But my friends, something changed in my life. Something changed one night when I put my faith in Jesus Christ. Something much more better than all the drugs in the world, than any drug that could ever get me high, came to dwell in me, and it was called peace.
What about care?
Jesus is Lord, my friend. And why is he Lord? How do I know he's Lord? Well, for 20 years of my life, I didn't believe in him. I wanted nothing to do with Jesus. I would have laughed at standing here and proclaiming to you that Jesus Christ is Lord. But that all changed. And it changed because I had a personal encounter with the Father through his Son. Everything changed. The way I see my fellow man, the way I see you all, I see you made in the image of God. You are not just animals. Don't listen to that lie. You are made in the image of God. You have an eternal soul, which will live forever. And all this takes is an encounter with Jesus. Jesus, what, he's about 6 foot, dark hair.
He's a Middle
Eastern man. Yeah. But you see, Jesus is the Son of God. Jesus is the Son of God. He's God the Son. And he came to dwell in me. And he set me free from cannabis. He set me free from spice. He set me free from alcohol. How is that possible? How is that possible when all I wanted to do was get high? There was no meaning to my life. All of us are meandering through life, not knowing what we're doing, not understanding why we're actually here on this planet. We try and distract ourselves. We try and confuse ourselves with different things. But deep down within us, we're all searching for this one question. What is life? No professor at any university can tell you what life is. They can never tell you how to find meaning in your days. Sure, they can give you a PhD. Sure, they can give you a degree. But my friends, that means nothing. It counts. It's a piece of paper. It's a piece of paper, that's it. But a relationship with God, a relationship with Jesus, a relationship with the Father, a relationship with the Holy Spirit is what this life is all about. You are made for communion with your Creator. Until you acknowledge that we are all made for the glory of God. We're not made for our own glory. There's no point chasing our own glory because we have none. There is no glory for man. But if we acknowledge this fact, that God loves us. God paid the price for us to go to heaven. Not when we die, but so heaven can come and dwell in us. The Holy Spirit can come and dwell in us by faith. All it takes is humbling ourselves. And don't get me wrong, it's humbling to admit that we've got a Creator. To admit that we have a higher power who we are responsible to. It is a humbling fact. We like to profess ourselves as gods. We like to have the power in our own hands. But my friends, this is slavery. Trying to be your own God is slavery. It's too much burden for any creature to take. Jesus said, come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Rest. We're all searching for rest. You're searching it for possessions. You're searching for it in meaning, for relationships. You're searching for it in alcohol, in party. You're searching for God, but you don't realize it. You're searching for the true meaning of this life. And this life is painful. This life can get you down. This life can seem painless. Without God, there's no point to this life. We're all just meandering. It's all just a quest for knowledge, a quest for power. But with my friends, there is one thing you need more than anything else. When you're laying on your bed tonight, acknowledge this fact. You need Jesus Christ. And when he was on the cross and he cried out, "It is finished. It is finished." We don't have to earn our way to heaven. We cannot earn our way to heaven. But my friends, you are all made in eternity. You will live for eternity. You will not just die like a dog. You will live forever, either in heaven, in paradise, where there is no hatred, there's no jealousy, there's no wrath, there's no anger, just perfect peace and holiness and love. But my friends, if we continue on our own stubborn way and we reject the love of God, then God gives us what we truly want, which is eternal separation from God. And my friends, the pain, the agony, knowing that hell is eternal. This is eternal, my friends. It terrifies me. Because I wake up on the morning and I know that my life is in the hand of God. My friends, we all need the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit must come and dwell in you. Otherwise, you will not understand the meaning of life. You will not understand why you are here on this planet unless you have the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of truth who comes to dwell in us, to be with there for us. Jesus said, "I will not leave you orphans. I will not leave you on this world on your own to fight the devil, to fight the world, and to fight the flesh. I will come and fight with you." Jesus says, in this world you will have tribulation. We all know that. We experience that on a daily basis. We are hard pressed. Suicide seems like the only way out. After 20 years I'm out on this planet, taking in the hostility, taking in the hatred, taking in the bitterness, and all I was searching for was love. I was searching for acceptance from someone to accept me, but no one would. Why? Because we all inherited a sin nature, and there's only one who can accept me, and that's Jesus. Now I don't strive for popularity, I don't strive for prestige, I don't strive for your acceptance of me. Why? Because God himself has chosen me before the foundation of the world. He's chosen me to come and dwell in his eternal home, in heaven, in paradise. I do not hope in this world. I do not hope in winning the lottery and getting rich one day. Because that is meaningless. It's vain. It's vanity of vanities. I hope in one thing. That one day I will meet Jesus Christ. One day I will stand before Jesus Christ. And I will fall before him and say, "Lord, thank you for dying on the cross for me. Thank you for taking my sin on yourself. Thank you for taking the wrath of the Heavenly Father for me. Thank you for loving me when no one else would." If you're alone in this world and you feel like no one loves you, no one cares for you, then my friends, I'm here to tell you there is one who cares for you, who loves you more than your own parents. And his name is Jesus. Do not recoil at his name. Just come to Jesus. Come to the light. He is the truth, my friends. He loves every single one of you within the sound of my voice. Jesus loves you. And he paid a price for you. A price for you to have peace. A price for you to have meaning in this life. For purpose. For joy.
For everything that we search for. We search for it in Starbucks. We search for it in bread. We search for it in every shop down here.
We are searching for something more than what we've got. Because we all acknowledge this, that the status quo is wrong. There is something wrong with the status quo. My life doesn't have true meaning. My life doesn't have true value. This is why I'm here in the middle of a city centre shopping, trying to accumulate something, to find meaning, to give myself estimation of my fellow man. Say, yes, this is the meaning of life. No, my friends, that's the lie of the devil. Your life is precious. You are not just an animal. You are not just a monkey. Your ancestor was Adam. Your ancestor was Eve. We are all of the same parents. So what, we look differently? It doesn't matter. We are all made by the image of God. Every single one of us is made by a creator. This is not just a meaningless universe. This did not happen by chance. But God has a purpose for your life. Jesus has a purpose for your life. He doesn't want you to be in bondage to fear anymore. He doesn't want you to live without purpose. He's got a purpose for your life. And he wants every one of you to come to him in love. For he is the author of love. God is love. He who does not know love does not know God. For God is love. My friends, I didn't wake up with this one morning. I didn't wake up with, you know what? I'm going to turn to Jesus. Oh, Jesus grappled me to the ground. I was a drug addict. I was an alcoholic. And Jesus grappled me to the ground and said, I'm going to love you and I will fix you. My friends, there is meaning. I have a relationship with Jesus Christ. He lives inside of me. He said, I will see you one day. One day I will behold his glory. We will all stand before Jesus. And those who have loved him and have received the love of the truth will rejoice. And we will spend an eternity in paradise. This life is so short. Before you know it, you'll be on your deathbed.
Before you know it, you'll be judged
before God himself.
Remember these words when you're laying in bed tonight.
Remember these words. God loves you. He sees what you're going through. He knows the pains and the struggles that you are going through. God made you perfect. Man fell. Sin entered the heart of man. This is why we're all inclined to be. Evolution doesn't make any sense. How can a man go to bed a monkey and wake up a man? How is that possible?
You got it, bro. It's a tadpole from a whale. This is not logical. There's no meaning to it. But there's meaning in Jesus. It's perfect.
So, you've got people talking to. Sharing the gospel there. People sharing the gospel there.
Whatever you experience on a daily basis.
I know it because I've been there.
I've lived on this planet for 23 years. I know what it's like to have no meaning in people's eyes.
And come to upstairs and look at people.
So looking for
acceptance from you all. I'm looking for acceptance. I was looking for you to love me. But no one loved me. No one cared for me. And this is true. Why? Because we live in a fallen world. We live under the power.